I'm delighted to share our exhibition entitled Avery, A Family Legacy with you and welcome you to our gallery. When I heard about the Fort Worth Modern Museum's major retrospective on Milton Avery, I thought, what an amazing opportunity to create some cultural synergy in West Texas, since Fort Worth is just a couple hours away. We put together this exhibition using our gallery inventory, focusing on Milton's family, Sally Michel, his wife, and March, their daughter. The Fort Worth Moderns show on Milton is beautiful, and our hope is that this will contribute to the conversation.
Walking around the gallery, one is struck by a joyful and whimsical tone in the room when surrounded by the delightfully playful and colorful works of the Averys. Their story as a family is so interesting and romantic, and linked inextricably to the development of American art in the 20th century. Milton met Sally when they were both at an artist's colony in Gloucester, Massachusetts. She was already a young painter. These two artists, including March as she got older, painted together regularly, evolved as artists together, and really developed this Avery style simultaneously. We can see in these delightfully charming and rather rare early watercolors from the late 1930s and mid-1940s that Milton and Sally's styles in their early careers were very similar, and you find similar subjects between the two artists. When on their lengthy summer holidays, they went out every day with their sketchbooks and drew side by side. They painted what was around them, hence they were often painting each other as subjects. You see these similarities in this charming 1945 watercolor of Milton and March reading by Sally Michel, and in the endearing drawing of March by the fireplace in their New York City apartment by Milton. The Avery style that Sally and Milton developed was marked in particular by a focus on color relations and the flattening of the picture plane. This is well illustrated in Sally's 1977 painting, Five Birches, and in March's striking work from 1962 entitled Orange Sand. These two pieces are wonderful examples of the unique color combinations and imagery distilled to its essential elements to create an abstracted, poetic, and yet realistic image, which are hallmarks of the Avery's paintings. In the summers, the Averys would travel on a shoestring budget as a family to places like Gloucester, Massachusetts, Vermont, Gaspé Islands in Canada, California, and Mexico, driving sometimes halfway across the country with their little girl in tow, renting meager accommodations, seeking fresh pictorial inspiration and a respite from city life. On these working vacations, they would go out every day with their sketchbooks, making drawings, which were later turned into gouaches and watercolors. Milton would only execute oil paintings once back in New York where they lived, and he was able to entirely focus on his career as an artist, while Sally successfully supported the family, working as an illustrator for magazines like the New York Times. But she would focus on her, quote, fine art during those summer trips. Sally's painting career was made secondary to Milton's, but she was a highly talented artist, and it is obvious that March absolutely had it in her genes, as she never attended art school, and she continues to paint today.
They Thank you for joining us to see our exhibition on Milton, Sally Michel, and March Avery. I hope you'll go to the Fort Worth Modern to see their retrospective on Milton, and that you'll come to our gallery in person to experience this remarkable family of artists.